My talk is on the modeling of circular traffic queues by cycloids. Maybe you already heard about cycloids. The notion is known from ancient astronomy. It has been used to model the apparent retrograde motion of a planet in the geocentric world model. The model was constructed by the superposition of a twofold circular behavior. It is not known whether Petri intentionally did refer to this model. By the end of this talk, I will present such a connection. Petri often introduced cycloids by a model of traffic items like cars, trains, production goods, computer tasks, or electronic particles. Starting from a stream of cars and gaps in between, we come to Petri's formulation of a space, namely an infinite net which is a T-net. It is important that the move of a car performs together with the move of the corresponding gap item, as can be seen in a simulation. Petri used the names Minkowski space and natural coordinates, but it is justified now to call it Petri space. The initial state configuration is an inclined line, which is used to restrict the space, say we consider a finite circular road. A finite model is obtained first by folding in space direction. Next, we do the same in time direction to obtain a finite and cyclic system. The structure is called the fundamental parallelogram of the cycloid. By the identification of all transitions denoted by A, we obtain the circular structure of a cycloid. For instance, we recognize that the path A, B, C, D, A becomes a cycle in the folding. We obtain a known structure, the four seasons net. Generally speaking, cycloids are a subclass of partial cyclic orders. They generalize the well-known token ring structure. They have been used by Petri to find basic electronic gates or to model the Lorentz transformation in relativity theory. Applications are conjectured for virtual token rings in group communications of middleware, for parallel data flow models, for iterative computations in hardware, combination of hardware and software, and stream processing and machine learning applications. In the fundamental parallelogram, we see the vertices O, P, Q, and R, and the parameters alpha and beta, which equal 2 and 1, as well as gamma and delta. Altogether, we have the cycloid 2, 1, 2, 1. All neighboring parallelograms of the same shape are folded together. This is formally done in a net folding from the Petri space into the cycloid. It has the property to merge equivalent elements. The correspondence equivalence relation is composed by a folding in direction of the x-axis and the eta axis. We found a more efficient and algebraic formalism to test equivalence, namely by checking that the application of the inverse of the matrix A has integer values. A is called the matrix of the cycloid. Its determinant is positive as it equals the number of transitions of the cycloid. The objective of this talk is to connect Petri's cycloids with different models of circular traffic queues. They are defined by a set, capital C, of traffic items, cars for short. In the paper, the model is defined by transition systems and rewriting rules. Here, we restrict to a graphical representation. Car A1 can move when in front of a gap. We take a message-oriented view, which is appropriate for Petri modeling. The leaving car sends a release message that his current position will be free. From the last position, we observe the circular behavior. Therefore, a circular representation would be better. Also, the gaps can be replaced by individual traffic items. They may be called counter cars, represented in blue color here. For the cyclic model, we need the number of transitions. It is computed by the minimal length of recurrent transition sequences that are sequences which reproduce a given initial state. Experiments show a surprising anomaly. For the case of three cars and five gaps, we obtain the length C plus G times C equals 24. Now we take one more gap and the number is 27, which is not surprising. However, after the switch to the case of counter cars, we obtain a value of 120 by a factor of 5. Even more surprising is the case with one more counter car, where the value is reduced now to 54. The explanation for this anomaly is the following formula, as proved in the paper. It contains a factor G divided by the greatest common divisor of G and C. Hence, if the GCD is different from 1, we have a kind of resonance between the streams of cars and counter cars. Here we have a cycloid which is not in fundamental diagram form. Question: what are the parameters alpha, beta, gamma, and delta? We can try to redesign it, but this is an inefficient solution. The synthesis theorem from 2018 takes as input parameters observable values of the net and returns the cycloid parameters. Tau 0 and tau A are the numbers of enabled and semi-enabled transitions, namely 2 and 4. They immediately give the values beta equals 2 and alpha equals 4, respectively. Then, by these formulas, gamma equals delta equals 1 are computed. They are using as inputs the number capital A equals 6 of transitions and the length CYC equals 2 of a minimal cycle. As a result, we obtain the cycloid 4211. However, in general, the result of the synthesis theorem is not unique, but all results are isomorphic if alpha is different from beta. For instance, these three cycloids are isomorphic. The synthesis theorem can be directly be applied to the circular traffic queue model with anonymous cars. We obtain beta equals 3, as there are 3 enabled cars, and alpha equals 4, as there are 4 release messages. With capital A equals 7 transitions and CYC equals 2, we obtain the cycloid 4311 again. Now we switch from the case of anonymous cars to the case of individual cars. Each car performs a separate processes. Hence, in this example, we obtain a number of beta equals 3 processes of length capital A divided by beta. This corresponds to a switch from black tokens in Petri nets to colored tokens. To apply the synthesis theorem, we use the values for alpha and beta as before, and our result for circular traffic queues for the number capital A of transitions. Here is the formula for the length of a minimal cycle CYC that will be motivated afterwards. With these values, the synthesis theorem is applied in a non-numerical form to obtain the result, namely the cycloid GCCC in general and 4333 in this example. The following animation shows our example cycloid by a colored net with 3 interacting processes in blue, red, and yellow. Here, the 3 cars are represented by colored tokens. In general, cycloids do not have this property of beta separate processes. Look at this example, 4, 3, 3, 4. We have only one process instead of three. What we want is a condition on the cycloid to have beta disjoint processes of length P capital A divided by beta. A process has length P if we have such a cycle. This holds if and only if T1 is equivalent to T8A, or in coordinates of the Petri space, 0, 0 is equivalent to P0. By the cycloid algebra, we obtain that the second component is an integer by the condition on P, but also the first component has to be an integer, hence beta has to be a divisor of delta. A cycloid with this property is called regular. The structure of regular processes generates corresponding coordinates, which are called regular coordinates. They make investigations easier for such cycloids. A representation with regular coordinates looks like this. Here we have beta equals 3 processes, again in blue, red and yellow, each of lengths p equals 7. A release message chain is a sequence of transitions of given release to their position, one to the other, like this, in this example, blue to red to yellow. It can be extended to a cycle called release message cycle of length 2 times c, which is minimal in the case g greater or equal c. By a similar construction, we solve the case of individual countercars. The used modifications are capital A with an additional factor G divided by delta, and C by C like this formula. We obtain a result which is different for the parameters gamma and delta, namely C increased by the factor G divided by delta. In the example, this results in the cycloid 4, 3, 12, 12. This has 84 transitions, a minimal cycle length of 21, and process length of 28. In our research, we did care about the basis only on the theory of cycloids for traffic queues. Let's look a little bit beyond by a little example. Here we have two models for three cars and two gaps, one with anonymous and one with individual cars. As just shown, the corresponding cycloids are 2, 3, 1, 1, and 2, 3, 3, 3. In between, we have the cycloid 2, 3, 2, 2. We ask, what is its behavior? All three cars are in line, as can be seen by this representation by a colored net. We have a traffic queue with three cars and seven gaps. On the right-hand side, we have the reachability graph. The cars are synchronized in a strange way. For instance, car C can make only two moves, even when in front of three gaps. This is an example of a non-standard synchronization mechanism. In general, we conjecture that by cycloids a theory can be built which is able to classify a great class of such synchronization primitives. By a second example, we show that our method applies also beyond T-nets. Here we have a regular cycloid for three cars and two gaps. What happens if a car crashes? In this example, the yellow car can crash. By the strong synchronization, the other cars will be blocked soon. A solution works as follows. These three places are merged as virtual or fusion places. The same is done for these groups, each of three places. By this construction, we leave the class of T-nets, but are still in the Petri space and can apply cycloid algebra. However, we have to add another morphism to merge the fusion places. In the renew execution of an equivalent colored net, the following steps are possible. Blue, red, yellow, and so on. This is repeated until the crash of the yellow car will happen. Here we have the crash of the yellow car. but the other two processes continue unblocked. Next, we consider the n-fold temporal iteration of a cycloid. It is obtained by multiplying gamma and delta with a positive integer n. Its equivalence relation is a subset of the original equivalence relation. The area capital A2 is the n-fold of area capital A1. The inclusion is proved by cycloid algebra again. The resulting vector for cycloid 1 has integer values, as this is the case for the resulting vector of cycloid 2. To give an example, consider our standard traffic queue with 3 anonymous cars and 4 gaps, which is isomorphic to the standard PetriNet queue and the cycloid 4-3-1-1. Then, the 3-fold iteration is isomorphic to 4-3-3-3. If we take 3 copies of 4-3-1-1, by composition we obtain again 4-3-3-3. Our cycloid can therefore be represented by 3 different formalisms. The first way is by the parameters 4-3-3-3 in this case. As just shown, the second way is by the standard PetriNet queue for anonymous cars, anonymous traffic items, and its 3-fold temporal iteration. To show the third way, we start with the standard colored PetriNet queue for individual traffic items. Then the cycloid is an unfolding of this colored net into a T-net. This is proved in a report that is cited in the paper. Now let us come back to the classical notion of a cycloid. If we take the cycloid 2222 from Petri's article in Theoretical Computer Science from 1996, we can build the 3-fold temporal iteration and obtain a dynamical behavior which may be compared to the classical notion of cycloids, or more precisely of epicycloids. The net cycloid is a discrete values model but is extended to have a concurrent behavior. A little summary of our results is given in this table. In the first column, we have our most important models: circular traffic queues with anonymous cars, with individual cars and gaps, with individual cars and counter cars. Then follow minimal lengths of cycles, the number of transitions, and the representation by iterations. Looking back, we have identified the cycloids which are behavior equivalent to circular traffic queues. We have investigated cases of individual cars and counter cars. We have shown an important applications of the synthesis theorem. We found the notion of release, message, chain and cycle. And we found the algebra of cycloids. Furthermore, we gave proofs of isomorphisms in the paper, cycloids as unfoldings of colored nets, extensions of the formalism, and representations by iterations. Thank you very much for your attention.